Dear friends, good morning. Satish, I had shown part of our dragon fruit garden in other video, and a lot of our friends had curiosity and were thinking a lot of things are required to grow dragon fruit. On the contrary, dragon fruit is a very simple cactus plant requiring literally no maintenance or minimal maintenance, and you hardly require 4 feet footprint, 2 feet width, 2 feet length, and 2 feet height, and any container will do. So this is a simple container that I have used. It's a used rice bag of 50 kilo rice bag, two layered, and as you can see, it has a red soil potting mix, and now one stem was put here, and as you can see closely, it will branch out. So you need a space for it to train, and suggested recommended way to train it is like you train any vine or runner, like grapes or basale or passion fruit. Only thing you need to ensure is it gets all the sunlight and warmth, so preferably select a place which has all the sunlight coming from morning to night, and doesn't have any shade of building or plant or tree on it. And preferably place it next to a compound wall or some place where it can train. I'm showing close up of roots. These are aerial roots which will cling on to your wall or any place you can see, and you can see how I have trained it. So any side branches that are coming out, you can cut them on the node and plant it. So best way is train it like this, like a runner, using a thread, preferably cotton. Don't use metal wire which will get heated up, and you can just ignore it for a couple of months. Once you start seeing new shoots, new growth, try to give well balanced NPK fertilizer manure. I use chemical fertilizer, so typically 16 by 16 by 16. That means nitrogen 16, phosphorus 16, and potassium 16. I give it twice a year, that is every 6 months. And some plants grow faster, and if you see any yellow spots or it's becoming light green, I give it. And whenever I give manure, I deep water it. Since our water is borewell water with around 700 ppm, I give magnesium whenever I give nutrients. And last year I gave water to this. Last year I gave water to this plant when I gave the fertilizer, maybe twice a year with NPK. And once you see the flower, first flower, you have to give it phosphorus, either with DAP or diammonium phosphate, or with super phosphate. Most of the time when you try to buy phosphate outside, even though they say rock phosphate, it will be most often super phosphate. And this plant requires lots of nutrition, so do not use organic methods. So once you see a first flower, phosphorus has to be given. And since we have borewell water, I always add little bit of magnesium whenever I give, and if I see any spots, any problem, I try to add micronutrients. So that's how it is. And once you see more flowers, it requires potassium, lots and lots of potassium. So I give MOP, which is muriate of potash. The fruit has lots of nutrients, lots of minerals, lots of useful things. So you have to give good nutrients. It's like kids. When you have a growing kid, you need to, or you will end up giving energy drinks, maltova, bonvita, cerelac, etc. So you need to take similar care to your plants. Some plants require more nutrition, so give it. Don't force feed your compost, home compost. And as in IT we say, garbage in, garbage out. So please ensure what you are giving to the plant has value, has. So please make sure whatever you give to the plant has a good value and good nutrition, and you'll get lots of harvest. As you saw in my video, previous one. So you'll be blessed by nature. So your hard work won't go wrong. So best of luck, and any query, any help, always feel free to reach via my forum or by comments. Thanks. Have a nice day.